Om Namah Shivaya. Hi friends, how are you? In this video, we are going to learn about simple columnar epithelium. Okay, simple columnar epithelium. First, description. The cells of the epithelium are much taller compared to their width. Nuclei are elongated and located in the lower half of the cells. All nuclei are placed at the same level in neighboring cells. See once again, description of simple columnar epithelium. The cells of the epithelium are much taller when compared to their width. Nuclei are elongated and located near the lower half of the cells. And all nuclei are placed at the same level. All nuclei are placed at the same level in neighboring cells. Okay. See this figure. This figure represents the simple columnar epithelium. Okay, this is the simple columnar epithelium. If you observe here, the cells are taller when compared and is compared to their width. Height is more than the width. Okay, and you observe the nuclei of this simple columnar epithelium, this like elongated are oval shaped. See, all are oval shaped. It is taller when compared to the width, and the nuclei is oval shaped and present in the lower half. Present in the lower half of the cells, of simple columnar cells. And all these nuclei are arranged in at same level when compared to the adjacent or neighboring cells. Okay, see here, the height of the cells in this epithelium is much greater than their width. The nuclei are oval, being elongated in the same direction as the cells. They lie near the bases of the cells. These nuclei lie near the bases of the cells. Because of this, we see a zone of clear cytoplasm above the nuclei. Because of this, we see a zone of clear cytoplasm above the nuclei. Okay. Next. A simple columnar epithelium, that means non-ciliated. This non-ciliated, simple columnar epithelium means non-ciliated columnar epithelium, lines the mucous membrane of the stomach and of the large intestine that we see later. See here, in vertical section of the cells of the simple columnar epithelium are rectangular. On surface view, are in transverse section, the cells are polygonal. In vertical section of the cells of the simple columnar epithelium are rectangular. On surface view, are in transverse section, the cells are polygonal. See the figure. See this figure. This represents the sectional view. Okay, the cells you are seeing here represents the sectional view. See, you are seeing this sectional view, and this is the surface view at transverse section. Okay, first see the sectional view. In sectional view of the simple columnar epithelium, and the cells seen are appear like rectangular. See, all the cells are look like rectangular. See, and the nuclei are oval shaped, present in the lower half of the cells and arranged in at same level. Arranged at the same level. Next, see here, in surface view are transverse section. The cells appears like polygonal. See here, the cells appears like polygonal. Simple columnar epithelium The basally placed oval nuclei, the cells appear hexagonal in surface view. Next, columnar epithelium can be further classified according to the nature of the free surface of the cells as follows. Columnar epithelium can be further classified according to the nature of the free surfaces of the cells. It is important nature of free surfaces of the cells as follows. In some situation, the cell surface has no particular specialization. This is simple columnar epithelium. Cell surface has no particular specialization. No particular specialization. We call that simple columnar epithelium. In some situation, the cell surface bears cilia. In some situation, the cell surface bears cilia. This is ciliated columnar epithelium. Okay. See this figure. This is the simple. Ciliated columnar epithelium. This is the cilia. Okay. This is the cilia. You see here clearly. Cilia. It bears, these cells bear the cilia. We call that simple. Ciliated columnar epithelium. Next, in other situation, the surface is covered with microvilli. In other situation, the surface is covered with microvilli. Although the microvilli are visible only with electronic microscope, they are seen as the striated border with the light microscope. When the microvilli are arranged regularly or as a brush border, when the microvilli are irregularly placed. See once again. In other situation, the surface is covered with the microvilli. Although the microvilli are visible only with the electronic microscope, as they are seen as the striated border with the light microscope. When the microvilli are arranged regularly, that means it seen striated border. When the microvilli are arranged regularly, when the microvilli are arranged irregularly or placed irregularly, it appears as brush border. Okay, see the figure. This is the columnar epithelium showing striated border made up of the microvilli. See, lightly. Okay. Are you able to find? See, guys, here. This is the columnar epithelium with showing is striated border made up of microvilli. We call that next location of simple columnar epithelium. Location of simple columnar epithelium. Simple columnar epithelium is present over the mucous membrane of the stomach and the large intestine. Simple columnar epithelium is present over the mucous membrane of the stomach and large intestine. Columnar epithelium with a striated border is seen most typically in the small intestine and with brush border in the gallbladder. See once again, columnar epithelium with a striated border is seen most typically in the small intestine and with a brush border in the gallbladder. Next, ciliated columnar epithelium lines most of the respiratory tract, the uterus, the uterine tubes. It is also seen in the afferent ductules of the testes and parts of the middle ear, auditory tube, the appendyma lining the central canal of the spinal cord and ventricles of the brain. See once again, ciliated columnar epithelium lines mostly of the respiratory tract, uterus, uterine tubes. It is also seen in the afferent ductules of the testes and parts of the middle ear, auditory tube, the appendymema lining the central canal of the spinal cord and ventricles of the brain. See this figure. This is the columnar epithelium showing striated border. It is in sectional view. Okay, this is in sectional view. This is the columnar epithelium with a striated border in the small intestine. Okay, in the small intestine it appears like this. See what is given here. In some regions of the free surface of the cells of columnar epithelium showing a thickening with vertical striations in it. This is a striated border. This is typically in the small intestine. This is the view of simple columnar epithelium with striate. It is a columnar epithelium with striated border seen in the intestine. This one, okay. This is the figure of simple columnar epithelium. This is simple columnar epithelium, not a ciliated one, which lining the mucosa of the stomach. The mucosa of the stomach is lined by simple columnar epithelium. Remember guys, simple, not the ciliated or any striated. Only the simple columnar epithelium lining the mucosa of the stomach. Next, coming to the functions of the columnar epithelium. Next, functions of the columnar epithelium. Okay, some columnar cells have the secretory function. The apical part of the cytoplasm contain secretory vacuoles. Secretory columnar cells are scattered in the mucosa of the stomach and intestines. In the intestines, many of them secrete mucus, which accumulates in the apical part of the cell, making it very light staining. These cells acquire a characteristic shape and are called goblet cell. Some columnar cells secrete the enzymes. In the respiratory tract, the cilia move mucus accumulation in the bronchi and containing the trapped dust particles toward the larynx and pharynx. When excessive, this mucus is brought out as the septum during cough. In the uterine tubes, the movement of the cilia help in the passage of ova toward the uterus. Microvilli increases the surface area for absorption. See once again the functions of the columnar epithelium. Some columnar cells have the secretory function. The apical part of the cytoplasm contains the secretory vacuoles. Secreted columnar cells are scattered in the mucosa of the stomach and intestine. In the intestine, many of them secrete mucus, which accumulates in the apical part of the cell, making it very light staining. These cells acquire a characteristic shape and are also called goblet cell. Some columnar cells secrete the enzymes. In the respiratory tract, the cilia move mucus accumulation. In the bronchi and containing the trapped dust particles toward the pharynx and larynx. When excessive, this mucus is brought out as septum during the cough. In the uterine tubes, the movement of the cilia help in the passage of the ova toward the uterus. Microvilli increases the surface area for absorption. Okay guys, this is about the columnar epithelium. Okay, if you like this video, see here, this is the striated border and these are the goblet cells. Okay guys, this is about the columnar epithelium. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe. Thank you.